project closed since Sewanyana is away.
Alan Sewanyana, the March India West legislator, has spent the last 15 months in prison since he was arrested in September 2021, together with the Kawempe North MP, Muhammad Segonya, and charged with cases of murder in connection to massacre killings. His continued incarceration has taken a huge toll on projects which the legislator had started in his constituency that can't be sustained by his parliament salary alone.
Parliament pays Sewanyana his salary. But as we all know, that salary is not enough to cater for all the activities of the Alan Sewanyana Foundation. More so, it is now looking after his family.
Today, the chairperson of Alan Sewanyana Foundation, Shafiq Lubega, met parents of children who have been benefiting from the MP's scholarship scheme at the MP's office in Machindye and discontinued the scheme, saying they have run out of funds to provide school fees.
The whole essence as why we are winding up the bursary scheme is the inability of the Alan Sewanyana Foundation to source for funds to pay for school fees when Alan Sewanyana, the main sponsor, is away.
Over 200 children have been getting assistance from the March India West legislator, who has been spending over 100 million per term on them. But Lubega says they are struggling to pay arrears, which they owe schools, since the MP has not been available to mobilize funds from development partners.
The bursary scheme had to stop. The SACCO also stopped midway, because it is again Sewanyana Alan who sourced for the initial 700 million shillings that was in the SACCO. Whoever picked this money, having heard that Sewanyana is now in prison, simply went and took it as a grant.
This shocked parents and they cried out to the government to do the needful to rescue their children, or else consider granting bail to their area MP to facilitate continuity of the scholarship program.
We are winding up the work of Alan Sewanyana Foundation, mainly because none of us, among us, the people of Makindye, can again sponsor us financially.
We also learned that Sewanyana was operating a SACCO dubbed Banyivu SACCO, whose capital had grown to 700 million shillings. However, according to the foundation chairperson, the SACCO started losing funds when the lawmaker was arrested, as debtors ran away with SACCO money, leaving them with no option but to close.
Partially, we had over between 170 to 200 kids he has been paying for, to the tune of 200 million shillings, which he would source around from various sponsors.
Sewanyana was also the president of Katwe United, a football club which was playing in FUFA Big League by the time of his arrest. His absence has taken a toll on the club, and it has been relegated to a lower league division due to lack of funds to keep players going. Today, the club was handed over to supporters as Sewanyana Foundation pulled out.
And as for Katwe United, we can no longer pay the players, and the contracted players all left. Katwe United is limping and performing very, very poorly.
Other projects that have been discontinued include the Border Border project, among others. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.